complete product. No matter from which culture, race, or society they belong. My people put their lives at risk to live happily. High-rise window washing is a dangerous business. And sometimes, in doing such a noble work, they lose their lives.
Can you pass us the buckets, please?
The what?
Yeah, you're going to get a bucket.
I don't want a bucket.
You're going to clean glass.
I don't want to clean glass. I just want to get down alive.
Let's go down. Low down, low down, low down.
Yeah. Would it not have been easier to do this with a machine?
No.
I could not do this for a job.
And according to International Window Cleaning Association, there are approximately 1.5 million exposures when workers are on the side of buildings each year. Let's have a look at what happened in 2014 when two window washers were stuck in the middle of a white wall building while washing the window.
Just last fall, next door at the 104-story One World Trade Center, one of the cables on the window washer's basket came loose, leaving two workers dangling outside the 68th floor for over an hour and a half.
Fortunately, they survived, but that doesn't happen every time, and many people lose their lives. Keeping this in mind, I work with my father to build a small-scale prototype of a robotic arm which can do this window washing work for us. The robotic arm will be operated and controlled by a mobile or tablet-based interface. To demonstrate the idea, I have wired a couple of electronic circuits. I used following components in my project: a stepper motor with pulley and belt for up and down motion, an ESP32 microcontroller to control the devices remotely, 12 volt power supply, a couple of LED lights, and of course some wires. The code for the project is given in the description box below. I'm including some needed libraries first. Then I'm entering the information for ESP32 to connect to the internet, like my Wi-Fi information. Once the initial setup is completed, the ESP32 is connected with the Wi-Fi. ESP32 is making an HTTP post request to my server to get the current command set for the robotic arm. This result, which ESP32 is fetching via HTTP post request, is saved by my web page. And you guessed it right, this is the operator interface for the robotic arm. Let me fix the robotic arm and show you guys how it works. The operator can turn the lift on or off. They can turn the cleaner head off or on. The hazard lights off or on. Switch the headlamp on or off. This is my school project for my idea to win. I need you guys to support me by liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching. Take care and bye bye.